down and bright. Edge of the water, we were feeling all right. Back down a country road, the girls are always hot and the beer is ice cold. Cadillac, horns on the hood. My buddy Frankie had his dad hook him up good. Girls smile when we roll by. They hop in the back and we cruise to the riverside. Whoa. Never gonna grow up. Whoa. Never gonna slow down. Whoa. We were shining like lighters in the dark in the middle of a rock show. Whoa. We were doing it right. Whoa. We were coming alive. Whoa. Yeah, caught up in a southern summer, barefoot blue jean night. Blue eyes and auburn hair, sitting looking pretty by the fire in a lawn chair. New to town and new to me, her ruby red lips was sipping on sweet tea. Shot me a little like a shooting star, so I grabbed a beer and my old guitar. Then we sat around till the break of dawn, howling and singing our favorite song. Never gonna grow up, never gonna slow down. We were shining like lighters in the dark in the middle of a rock show. We were doing it right. We were coming alive. Yeah, caught up in a southern summer, barefoot blue jean night. Whoa, oh, never gonna grow up. Never gonna slow down. We were shining like lighters in the dark in the middle of a rock show. We were doing it right. We were coming alive. Whoa. Yeah, caught up in a southern summer, barefoot blue jean night. Whoa. Barefoot blue jean night. Barefoot blue jean night. Barefoot blue jean night.
FOMC was obviously a fake news event today. today. We did call that out in the room. If there is a long at during the news event to sell the news event, this is all too obvious now to us what's going on in most cases. So we don't really care, about the trade. I'm not really interested in it. But the Swiss is the ones we want to try to hold for the entire weekly time frame. What are the other ones we're working on? I think there was, let's just look at the euro dollar. We did that as well, didn't we? Yeah, there it is. We got out of that earlier. Those are still in play. We'll come to those in a minute. We'll look at the Swiss. And yeah, that's it. I'm just really doing New Zealand and Swiss. So, New Zealand first was pound. This here was just a reload today in the end of New York, which we'll get rid of now. Are we expecting this to go much further? Let's find out. If the dollar goes up, that will naturally weaken the New Zealand. It will also weaken the pound and the euro. So it won't change anything with that euro and pound New Zealand trade, if that makes sense. So this was last night. The arrow is there somewhere. You can see it in the green. There it is, you see. So we drew that in anticipation of New Zealand coming up, which it has done. The weekly strongest respected pair to the New Zealand is the Aussie, because the Aussie is going up. The New Zealand is not as able to go up against the Aussie as strong as it is. Is that telling us something? We're just expecting Aussie to keep going up and give us the illusion that Aussie is following these. In this perspective, on the 1 minute, it would appear that the 1 minute guys are getting too long in New Zealand. We are happy about the move, so we will, because of that, we will take off some of this. Zealand will draw here a little place where 1 minute guys got too long, and we'll monitor that for later. we know it's in this area. We don't. It doesn't need to be exact point, because remember, it's just an average. We're just looking for an average, and that's what this is here. It's really in the middle. So retail bought. So we leave it as a green line, and we will anticipate some sort of sell-off some stage. So yeah, it may have some legs still, and to allow the 5 minute to do the same thing, you know. I remember what this was doing on a high time frame. Not a lot. Here is how to simply double hedge something. Let's look at that now. So, let's just imagine we were trading here that day, and we look back, and we'd see that Aussie has gone up more. See, New Zealand has not gone up as much, so the ideal thing to do would be to buy New Zealand and sell Aussie, because New Zealand will likely have a lot higher move going towards the Aussie. And let's say Aussie collapses, well, and we're here at this point. Well, if Aussie collapses and New Zealand collapses, New Zealand is not going to go as far down as Aussie, because New Zealand is already low. I hope that makes sense. So that is how to do a hedge. But the double hedge would be to find another currency doing the exact same thing on the exact same time frame that you'd be able to piece together, if that makes sense. And let's just do that for the purpose of this video. We were on a 15 minute time frame, and just go back there somewhere in the middle here, right? And somewhere in the middle here. So if we looked left, these moving averages are going to tell us anyway. If we can't, we don't want to get too into that. It's going to help in emergency. We see they're more open than euro. So that means that pound has already gone up further than euro at that time. And it's the same here with Aussie and New Zealand. They're more open relative to these. They're all chopped up, you see. This is more consistent. But we don't read these. Don't look at these EMAs. They're telling you the same exact thing anyway that we're looking at. And that's why it looks more complex here, because it's just chop. But the deal is you would be more long euro than pound. So if at this point you did a pound New Zealand short from around this area, you'd be quite happy right now. So that's why we were so confident in this pound New Zealand, because this is the area, and as usual, pound did a crazy move. You have to expect that. So we'll have the fine tuned entries perfected at some point, I'm sure. Anyway, I think there was Swiss. Let's look at that real quick. That was from yesterday. Okay. A little move and it did it. Now it's back up. It's done its main move that we were looking for. Swiss up. Now we're looking for a Swiss down. We'll bring the yellow over the LFX over at the same time. So if you're just looking at one perspective, you won't see what's going on. So that's telling us nothing. But we know it's a weekly trade. There. I think it's zoomed in a fractal perhaps. On this one. But we don't, should we do the yen? Oh yeah, let's just do it against the yen for argument's sake. Alright, so look, Swiss is already up higher than the yen index. You can see in the averages just there. Without looking at them, we know that Swiss is higher. So you'd be wanting to sell Swiss and buy LFX if you were taking that. And then here, it's still the same thing. But really, a better trade would be something that's lower down here. So let's find that. Let's have a look for that. And really find the best trade. I think it's CAD, isn't it? Yeah, I think it's CAD. Aussie's kind of weak, but a little high relative to those. Long Aussie and short Swiss. So a long on Aussie Swiss would be a nice trade. There's nothing wrong with that. Let's do that. I think yeah. Let's enter that as well. We already got one going. Okay. Well, that's fine. I'm happy with that. Should we buy another one? Yeah. Let's buy another. Like buying after a rally in price because it's not a discount anymore, but we do have so much time with this Swiss, we're gonna do it. So the Swiss today is here from last night, and it's like, you know, obviously that's gonna happen because the Swiss is also strong. So on that note, we're gonna just end it and not even waste our time with these yens relative to Swiss at this point, because they're both pretty strong and likely to drop. So, hang on a minute, if we think about this, if Swiss drops and yen drops, then Swiss yen's going to drop, but it's not a double hedge, and that's what we're looking for here. So, Swiss, what else is there? Let's check USD. USD relative to Swiss. So I'm excited about that one. Let's find the good one. What's the pound doing? Oh, This is just too good. All right. Yeah. Right. So we're going to be long pound Swiss, and now let's just look at euro at the same time, because we know the euro will have to make give us a bit of an advantage also. Right, because euro and pound work together. So euro relative to pound at this time is a little stronger by the looks of things. Yes, it's more trading higher. Indicators have been open for less time, not really much follow through. They've come down this year. It's done one. Yeah. Well, it doesn't go any further back, so. So if euro is stronger than pound, we want to be long pound and short euro as a hedge. And Swiss relative to USD, well, we've just established that one, guys. So let's go ahead and draw our large weekly arrow in. Get the idea, we'll put that in as red, and we'll continue to load up on these positions when we can. Hang on a minute.
Turn the quiet up, turn the noise down, let this old world just spin around. I wanna feel its sway, wanna feel its sway, put some feel good in my soul. Drag a little drink, smoke a little smoke, want a little more right.
Smoke a little smoke.